Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're gonna open up the January box for Glossybox. You might have noticed that we skipped the December box for Glossybox, and I feel oh so bad about that, but I did get it really late in December, and at that point I had injured my wrist, so I was not doing any editing anymore. Because of that same injury, we weren't posting very much in January, and I did get this a couple weeks ago, a week ago, I don't know, but it's been a while that I've had it. But I just wasn't up to editing a bunch of videos while my wrist was still hurting me. Glossybox sends this box to me for free as PR, and I'm so appreciative of being on their PR list because this is one of my favorite boxes. So I'm a little sad that I missed posting December for them, but they did ask if it was possible if I could post January by January 31st. Today is January 31st, so I am filming, editing, and posting it all in the same day. So you'll probably see it the night of January 31st, but happy end of January. I cannot believe we flew through January this fast. So let's try to speed through it. One of my favorite things is that it has a pull tab. Requires no scissors. I cannot be trusted with scissors. We cannot be trusted with scissors on this channel. Somehow I still always have them, but Glossybox takes care of that for me. And I just love it so, so much. This is their classic pink box. Not my favorite color, if you know, but it is very on brand for them. And always the packaging is just too much in a good way, like super cute. Our theme says revival on the front, and then it's gonna have all of the products, including their prices inside, with a cute little bow every single time. And here is our box of fun stuff. So let's start with the brand Seed Phytonutrients. This is their lightweight facial lotion. And the bottle says supporting independent American farmers who grew our camelina and sunflower seeds. This says for normal to oily skin. The other side said 99% natural origin, no animal testing, paraben-free, gluten-free, vegan, and a natural fragrance. First ingredient here is water. Second ingredient is caprylic or capric triglyceride. It is coconut oil, but is the one form of coconut oil that I do put on my face. Pulling it out, it is in a glass bottle, amber color. Definitely love that. Love it when my skincare comes in a glass bottle. And if it also is, you know, a little bit more safe from light with amber or blue color, even better. Because I don't have a million years to edit this, I am not gonna do a full try on like research like I normally do, but I will be bringing those videos back next month. Thank you guys so much for your patience while my hand has been healing. As you can see, it's back to its normal self. There's no, last time this part right here, like basically from this bone up was completely swollen, and now it's like completely normal again. It has a very clean, refreshing scent, so I do like that about it. I really love this box because it's items that I normally don't find in other boxes. Definitely have not seen this item before. And then next we have Bioderma. Look how big this is. This is a purifying cleansing micelle solution. So micellar water, definitely really good for taking your makeup off and also pretty gentle usually. This one says no rinse, paraben free, and hypoallergenic. So you just put this on a cotton pad, and I think we got cotton pads this time too. Yes, we did, reusable rounds, so I'll do that one next. So you just put that on and it should take your makeup off. It usually takes your makeup off. Micellar water for me has been really good, especially when I had eyelash extensions. So next let's do the after spa. So after spa, it's two pack. And it says easy makeup removal while preserving the planet. If you know me, you know that I love that. These are so soft. And it does say it's machine washable, like washing machine washable on the back. They feel like really soft. Some of it is kind of like, you can see that in front of my face. So I do think I would probably wash them first once before I start putting them on my face and like make all these little things flying. I think it definitely helps if you wash something at least once before you start using it. The next product is from Kors, and this is their Hydrobiome Probiotic Superdose Face Mask. It says it's created with real Greek yogurt, so that means it's definitely not vegan. Made in Greece. Let's see if there's anything else interesting on here. Synthetic fragrance-free. So fragrance-free is like no fragrance whatsoever, including essential oils. And then synthetic fragrance free is no chemical fragrance. Chemical fragrance, technically it's protected by trade secret laws, so they don't have to tell you what type of chemicals are in them. And a lot of times they can hide chemicals that you're trying to avoid or that are really bad for sensitive skin in fragrance, because when they write fragrance, it's actually a collection of all those chemicals. So when it says synthetic fragrance free, that just means it doesn't have any chemicals, but it could still have essential oils for scent. So let's give this one a smell. I will say that I don't like the other products that Kors has with Greek yogurt. They just don't agree with my skin. I don't think they're bad products. I do think Kors has like some really good products, but for some reason, whatever is in the yogurt usually doesn't agree with my skin. It has kind of like a nutty scent to it. Yogurt is full of probiotics. That's one of the reasons why people love yogurt. It's like really good for gut health. So that's fun, but I will probably give that one away to a family member or friend just because the other rest of the Kors line that has yogurt has not done the best for my skin, but I do see that it has pretty good reviews. So the next product is from High, and this says High Maintenance Peeling Mask. This says it's made with cannabis sativa seed oil. I always get worried because all of the cannabis beauty stuff to me, it smells just like cannabis, and I don't like that scent. This one's not bad at all. This one smells more like alcohol than anything else. Okay, so you can actually already see it peeling on my hand. I'm gonna have to bring you closer up. Also, this is really gross. I really hope that that is not all the skin of my hand. That's so gross, and I also feel like there's no way it can work that fast. Sometimes I think that those products like already have it in the gel and it's not actually your skin. I know some people have done some tests where they rub it on like a balloon or a glass. And if they see it on the glass, they're like, okay, so it totally didn't take anything off. The last thing is a sample, and it says an extra treat on it. So everything was either a full size or deluxe mini. This was a full size, and this was a full size. So we got two full size items, and then these were deluxe minis, and this just says two packs. So I don't know if they're counting that as a deluxe mini. I don't know how many you would normally get from After Spa. But then this is just a like sample. And this says Smarter CBD from Zolt, THC-free, 20 milligrams, and it looks like it's just something you put in your drink. It says coconut, caffeine-free hemp extract. The instructions say combine one mixie stick, that's what this is, with 16 ounces of water. That's it. That's pretty cool. There's a bunch of flavors here. Passion fruit, tropical, lemon tea, peach tea, unflavored, and then honey citrus tea. I love coconut, so I guess I am glad I got this, but I don't know that I like coconut by itself, but maybe if I mix it with pineapple juice, that would be super good. So we're gonna do mini research, just basically like what is the score, how many reviewers, and where is it made? I can't find where this is made. It just lists like the address here that says Pennsylvania, so it might be US made, but there's nothing on here that says US made, and I checked the bottle as well. But this product does get a 4.3 star rating with only 14 reviewers though. So not enough reviewers on this one. I think in general, I always see pretty good reviews about this brand though, Seed Phytonutrients. So this does look like it's probably a deluxe sample because the full size comes with three of these instead of two, and then two that are a little bit larger. So a total of five. So two out of five, I think this is probably would be considered a deluxe sample, but down here it just says a two pack. This gets a 4.3 star with 62 reviewers, and then some of the negatives were kind of weird. Like one said it's not soft, which it totally feels soft to me. And then another one was like, I didn't want this. And then someone else said, these are not disposable, which isn't that the whole point of reusable rounds? Like it literally says reusable cotton makeup removers. So why did they buy them? I don't know, but the negative reviews don't really seem to have a trend. It just seems to be like random people that didn't know what they were getting, or maybe somehow they got this in a box like this and that's why they were writing the negative review. It says they are 100% polyester, that they are recyclable, not tested on animals, and this is made in Mexico. So for the next product, the Bioderma Sebium H2O, whatever, the micellar water, has a 4.7 star with 2,002 reviewers, and when you cross the 2,000 review mark and you still maintain your 4.7 rating, that means you do what you say you're gonna do. So 4.7 means like literally almost nobody gave this a negative review. That means probably really gentle, also really is taking off your makeup. This product says made in France, and this is definitely full size. Look at, I could barely fit it in my hand, come on. For the Kors mask, this one is a 4.5 star rating with 485 reviewers, and this product is made in Greece. This is a trial size, so the full size is $49 for 100 milliliters. This is 1/5, and they're saying $10, and that's pretty accurate. The next product is the High Maintenance Peeling Mask. This does not tell me where it's made. It is a sample size, and their calculation said $20. My calculation doing milliliter for milliliter is $18.40, pretty close. This one does not have the best reviews, but it only had like 4 or 5 reviews anyways, but it just seemed like the ones that I did read that weren't on their website or were not on Glossybox website, because I don't like to use those. So I did it on the back of my hand, and it does feel really good where I used it. So maybe that really was my dead skin, which is so gross. I'm sorry that I made you look at that, but I don't know. My hand feels good. So I have a feeling that maybe it was working, but I have seen other people use products like this, not this particular product, on like a glass, and the same thing happens, like it pills up so it looks like it's skin, but really it's just whatever was in the gel. I think they count the sample in here for like part of the retail value. They say that that stick is worth $3.20 for that Zolt. So if we don't count the sample and doing a milliliter for milliliter, and for this it was a 5-pack for $10, so a 2-pack I put would be $4. They're saying the retail value for this is $10, but you could get 3 of these plus 2 of the bigger ones for the exact same $10 on Afterspa site. So I just like to do my own calculations the way that I feel like really represents what I think I'm getting my value. So using my numbers, it's $81.10 is the retail value. This box usually goes for $21. You can always get it for less, either by, you know, doing a whole year or 3 months or 6 months at a time. They even let you do a whole year, like commit to a whole year, but still pay every single month. So it doesn't come out all in one payment. You still pay it monthly. You're just saying that you're gonna pay for the whole year. That brings down your price too. So I do love that about this box. If you don't want to buy like a year or 3 months or 6 months to get a discount, you can also use my discount code, which is Jessica16, and that'll give you your first box for $16. So $81 for $16. Great deal either way, no matter what you choose. I'm gonna link my link down below, and I'll leave my discount link as well. It is not an affiliate link. I don't get anything if you use it. So if you find something better, please use something better. You are not helping my channel. I guess you're kind of helping my channel, because it is telling Glossybox, hey, she's doing a good job. She loves your box. Keep sending it to her. So it does help keep Glossybox on my channel. As always, let me know what your favorite item is in the comments down below. I'm a huge lover of micellar water in general, and like the fact that I'm getting this huge one that has such great reviews, this is gonna last me forever. I put these on my makeup erasers, like those makeup removing wipes that are not wipes, that are not disposable. I live on micellar water, and those, they're just like the perfect combo for getting all of my makeup off. And I like to wear a lot of makeup sometimes, and a lot of waterproof makeup sometimes. So I think that's gonna be my favorite. In the comments, let me know what your favorite is. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.